Do you know baptism is a sacrament performed after a person accepted Jesus Christ as their Savior and Lord of their life?
所以大家知道吗？洗礼是一个人当接纳主耶稣基督成为他个人救主后所接受的一种的洗礼仪式。
Before the arrival of the Messiah, the Jews practiced baptism as a traditional act of cleansing and conversion to Judaism.
所以在弥赛亚还没有降临之前呢，犹太人就把洗礼当作是一种传统的洁净行为，或者是皈依啊犹太教的一种的仪式。
You see on the slide, it provided the scripture, which is Levitical priests were also commanded to undergo symbolic cleansing in water before and after performing their priestly duties.
所以你也可以看到，就是说，在立位记里面呢，这些立位的这些祭司们也被命令在履行他们祭司职务的前后呢，也在水中要接受这种象征性的洁净礼。
The baptism of repentance that John preached has also followed this pattern of cleansing.
就像施洗约翰所传讲的那个悔改的洗礼，也遵循了这种洁净的模式。
Now turn with me to Book of Mark, chapter 1, verse 1 to 8.
让我们一起翻开马可福音第一章一至到八节。
Michael will be reading verse 1 to verse 4 with English. 等下 Tommy 弟兄再以中文的来读第五到第八节。So I repeat again, Mark chapter 1, verse 1 to 8.
马可福音第一章一至到八节。
Okay, verse 1.The beginning of the gospel about Jesus Christ, the Son of God, it is written in Isaiah the prophet. I will send my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way. A voice of one calling in the desert, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight paths for him. And so John came, baptizing in the desert region and preaching a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins.
第五节犹太全地和耶路撒冷的人都出去到约翰那里承认他们的罪，在约旦河里受他的洗。约翰穿骆驼毛的衣服，腰束皮带，吃的是蝗虫野蜜。他传道说，有一位在我以后来的能力比我更大，我就是弯腰给他解鞋带也是不配的。我是用水给你们施洗，他就要用圣灵给你们施洗。
NowMark was not one of the 12 apostles who followed Jesus Christ day and night throughout the 2.5 years.
所以大家要知道，就是马可不是那一位十二个耶稣的十二个使徒里面一个每日都跟主耶稣在一起的。
But he wrote the account of Christ dictated by Peter, and Mark's gospel is a book of that emphasized Jesus' identity as a servant.
不过呢，马可是从这个彼得口述之后他所写下来的，而且他也是这一卷书呢，福音书呢，就是强调主耶稣成为一个仆人的那种的身份。
The locals in Rome believed in many gods, so the author himself wants readers to realize that Jesus is the one and only true Son of God.
所以当时罗马人所信奉的是多神的那种的这种的多神论者，所以他就是要把这个作者呢，就是要把主耶稣介绍给他们，告诉他们这是主是神唯一的独生的真正的儿子。
So in the beginning of Book of Mark, we must realize that gospel plus baptism equals the path to eternal life.
所以从这个第一章里面呢，这个马可福音里面，我们就可以看到福音加上这个洗礼呢，就等于永生之路。
Let's pray together.
我们一起祷告。
Dear Heavenly Father, use your servant today, this morning, to preach your word. Not my word, but your word. May your will be done in this church as in heaven. May your word truly let your people understand, fully receive what you have been trying to tell us in this whole year 2023. We ask that you give us wisdom to understand today's message. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Before I continue, let me just say that this is the second week of Advent.
在我还没有继续之前呢，我要跟大家讲，这个就是代降节的这个第二个主日。
Now, Advent symbolizes the church's present situation in these We so-called last days as God's people wait for the return of Christ in glory to consummate his eternal kingdom.
所以这个代降节呢象征着教会在这个末后的日子里面，这种的现状，我们等待荣耀的基督，等待他荣耀的国度降临。
The church is in a similar situation to Israel at the end of the Old Testament.
所以我们现今教会的处境跟旧约里面以色列这个最后的那一个处境，末期的时候是很相似的。
Such as in exile, waiting and hoping in prayerful expectation for the coming of the Messiah.
特别是在他们的那个时候呢，是在流亡之中等待弥赛亚的临到。
That is why John the Baptist came to baptize the people.
所以这就是为什么施洗约翰在当时呢，会开始给人家施洗。
So I'll tell you why later. Now, first point, preparing hearts to turn back to the Lord, verse 1 to 4.
所以我们来看这个，就是把人的心呢，第一点呢，预备人的心回转归向神。
Jesus, in Hebrew word, is called, actually, is Joshua, which means the Lord is salvation.
所以耶稣在希伯来文的意思呢，他的读音是约书亚，意思就是耶和华的拯救。
He was sent to the earth to save his people from their sins.
他被差遣来到世上，就是要使百姓从这个罪恶当中被解放出来。
Christ is the post of the Lord Jesus, and the Hebrew word is called Messiah, which means the anointed one.
所以基督是主耶稣的这个职分，希伯来文来说呢，他就是弥赛亚，意思是受膏者的身份。
He was sent to be the anointed king, the anointed priest, and the anointed prophet in the kingdom of God.
他被差遣来的时候呢，在神国度里，他是一个受膏的君王、受膏的祭司以及先知。
More than 700 years before the New Testament period, Isaiah had prophesied that the Savior Jesus and pioneer, which is John the Baptist, would come to Israel.
所以在这个新约还没有开始700之年前呢，这个先知以赛亚已经预言了这个弥赛亚以及施洗约翰的那一种的世界了。
People have been waiting for 400 years for the coming of the great prophet, the Messiah prophesied in the Bible.
所以百姓们已经等了400多年，就是要希望可以等待到那一位伟大的先知，就是在旧约里面先知以赛亚所预言的那一位的弥赛亚临到世上。
In the scripture it says, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight paths for him. Indicates that John the Baptist's mission is to pave the way for the Lord and prompt people's mind to return to him.
所以当这里我们讲到预备主的道，修直他的路的时候，就是指明是约翰的任务，就是替主铺路，促使人的心思回转归向主。
So that the Lord himself can have a path to enter people's heart and reign as king.
所以好使主有这个平坦的这个道路呢，能够进到他们的心中，成为他们生命之主。
John's baptism was a renunciation of sin and a selfish way of life.
所以施洗约翰的这个洗礼呢，他是叫人唤醒人们离弃罪恶以及自私自利的那种的生活方式。So
he took the familiar custom and gave it a new meaning called, which is the baptism of repentance.
他就采用了那个为人所熟悉的那种当时的以色列人的习俗，并赋予新的意义，就叫做悔改的洗礼。
Everyone can follow me? Understand?
大家可以明白哈。
At least not everyone close eyes fall asleep. Yeah. Okay. Then let me quickly introduce this our speaker first. Okay. All right.
现在来介绍这个诗歌布道会的讲员。
Now Pastor Jeremy comes from Seremban, and his family has been troubled by witchcraft, evil spirits, debts, disease, etc.
所以这个呢，这个 Pastor Jeremy 呢，他的中文名字叫做黄宏阳，他是来自芙蓉这个地方的，他家中曾被那一些降头巫术邪灵黑道债务等顽疾等等被缠绕着。
In other words, we can say that he comes from a family surrounded in darkness.
所以换句话说呢，可以说他的那个家庭呢是被黑暗所笼罩的一个不幸的家庭啊。
After experiencing countless disturbance from evil spirits, he was once singing the lament of life.
所以他曾经历过这些无数邪灵干扰他，使他唱出那种生命的哀歌来。
Until he came to church and was released by the power of the Lord Jesus, witnessed the whole family receiving new life, he is now singing Love of Life.
直到他来啊，来到教会和接触到主耶稣自己啊，这个释放罪、解救罪的那个大能之后呢，见证了全家人得到新生命之后呢，现今他唱的这一首，每一首都是生命的爱歌。
Dear brothers and sisters, at this Christmas gathering and testimony sharing at December of 23rd, are we willing to come and listen Pastor Jeremy's beautiful songs and experiencing life changes in his testimony?
所以，亲爱弟兄姐妹们，我们愿不愿意，就是说，在12月23号的时候，我们自己来，我们也邀请我们的亲友来这个见证分享会呢，来听他宣讲他自己的这个生命的这个道，以及他的这个优美的诗歌呢
？Well, perhaps we might never encounter or experiencing all these unfortunate things all at the same time with our whole life.
我们在生命之中可能没有像他经历着那样多的那一种的波折起起落落哈
，such as chasing by along, cursed by other people, and having terrible disease such as cancer or tumor, all at the same time in your whole life.
就是说在他生命里面，他前半段呢都是被这一些的啊缠绕的疾病的这个缠绕啦，被阿龙追债啦等等那种啊邪灵的侵袭等等。
Have anyone been through that before, brothers and sisters?
我们有没有这样多？好像刚才所讲的哈，就是被巫术啊、邪灵啊、黑道啊那种阿龙追债的那种，全部记在一个人的身上吗？有经历过吗
？If God, we invite you at next year New Year be the speaker, okay? We want to listen your testimony also.
假如有的话，就你就是明年的这个讲员了哈。
哦，是啊 ，okay. But you know, if Let's imagine or think about this. If Pastor Jeremy and his family in this situation can be changed by the love of God,
假如我们想看，就是这一个弘扬这个传道 Pastor 他所经历这个事情能够在他的家以及他自己身上发生的话
，and they can change into a new person in Christ,
然后把他改变成为一个在主里面新造的人。
Then what about us? Have we truly experienced God's great love in this whole year 2023?
相对于我们来说，我们又怎么样呢？我们在2023年已经到年尾了，我们有没有经历主自己对我们的这个大爱以及引领呢
？For sure, we have really experienced God's love, but sometimes we'll feel God don't love me today. God love me tomorrow. God love me yesterday. God love me I don't know when. So.Why not we take this opportunity to come and experience God's love again?
但是很多时候我们还是会质疑神自己的爱哈。我今天需要他的时候，他不在我身边；我明天需要他的，他也不在我身边。我们在质疑神到底有没有真正的爱过我们。
所以欢迎大家来教会，吃秋瓜，吃好了，听经经，好不？
我们就一起来教会，来一起来唱诗赞美神，然后来听主自己的话。
我以为你听不懂福建话，所以我本来要你讲那个福州话的，你再讲多一次。对，
可以了，可以了。欢迎大家哈呀！神灵，我你的生活的时候，你这边我能你听到，我能你听见。
All right, 我们要竞争了，可以继续讲下去。Second point, cultivating hearts to receive Holy Spirit, verse 5-8.
所以第二点，我们来看到修炼人心，领受主的灵哈。我记载在第五节直到第八节。
The message preached by the John the Baptist affected people throughout Judea.
是约翰所传的这个信息呢，影响了全犹太全地的人。
This was the result of God preparing people's heart come to John the Baptist to repent their sins, to admit their sins and repent.
所以这就是人，这就是神啊，预备了人的心哈，让他们可以受来到这个约旦河来受约啊，施洗约翰的这个洗礼的结果。
John's main message is that the Messiah is coming, and the call to repent is a response to the coming of Christ.
所以施洗约翰的这个主要的信息是弥赛亚要来了， 悔改的呼召是对基督即将来临的回应。
Now, he was willing to live a simple life, live in the wilderness and giving up honor before men, wearing camel hair clothes, not relying on human supplies, and eating locusts and wild honey.
所以我们可以看到，他在这个旷野里面呢，他是甘心过做一个很简朴的这个生活方式。住在旷野里面，就是他放弃了人前的一切的这个荣耀，穿骆驼毛的那个衣服，不仰赖人的供应，吃的也是蝗虫、野蜜等等。
我想在这里先对这些小朋友问一下，你们知不知道，你们有在彩画你们的纸张吗？有在 做你们的那个该提供给你们的纸张吗？
So, yeah, the...
不要紧，不必翻译啊，我直接跟 okay. 小朋友讲话，就是感谢主了，这一次纸越来越不够了，孩子越来越多出现了，不知道你们喜不喜欢，不，你们知不知道你们现在在彩画那一个人叫施洗约翰，他活出怎么样的，他在哪里生活吗？他又穿成怎么样的样子吗？你们想想看一下，你们看一下那个画面，或者看一下这个荧幕这个 slide 上面 ，OK。Now let's talk about this John the Baptist. Let's imagine how he survived in desert with less what we call less water resources to find one.
所以我们来想象当时施洗约翰的这个情况是怎么样啊？当时你知道沙漠里面那个食水的供应是缺乏的。
In January next year, in Penang, at least in this area, 4 days without water.
所以我们也在 BBMC 里面也看到这个信息，就是明年一月的十多号会有4天食水断供的这个事情将在冰岛发生，特别是在这个地区了。
How many of you have already take your leave and take an excuse go on vacation not in Penang already one?
所以啊，到底
already book your flight or is it book your trip already is it?
Okay, yeah, 有到底多少人已经为这个时间已经未雨绸缪哈
？And some more, the 14th of January is Sunday 来的。
And then the first day the it is on the Sunday, 14th of January.
Yeah, so 教会到底会有崇拜吗？没水耶。
So
even 4 days, we already cannot handle no water already. Okay, think about John the Baptist.
所以就算四天呢，我们都已经不能耐了哈。所以我们来想象施洗约翰当时的情况。
But because of this kind of intention, he is free from worries and concerns of human nature. He can simply be the outlet of God's word and freely be the pioneer of Christ.
但是因着他有这样的这个心智就脱离人间的这些一切的顾虑、挂虑等等忧虑、挂虑等等，单单信靠神自己的话语而活。
Now John drew everyone's attention to the Son of Almighty God, and he led the world to Jesus Christ through the baptism of repentance.
所以施洗约翰把众人的眼光都引向这个全能神的儿子，他借着悔改的洗礼，把世人都引向耶稣基督。
Now in the scriptures, talking about untie the shoes. Okay, let me explain. Such as taking off shoes, carrying shoes, and washing feet for the master or the guest are the tasks performed by the lowliest servants.
所以在新约里面讲到的就是替主人或者是来宾来脱鞋啦、洗脚啦、提鞋啦等等，都是最低微的仆人所做的工作。
Do you know John the Baptist sometimes in the Bible it has been mentioned or comparing him as in the Old Testament the great prophet called Elijah?
所以大家有没有就是看到说，就是这个施洗约翰他就好比旧约里面的这个以利亚先知？
常常我们都是这样，常常在经文里面或者耶稣自己本身都把施洗约翰比较成他是这个要来的这个以利亚这个先知。But he considered himself is more lowlier than all these servants.
但是施洗约翰自己的本身，他就把他自己的职位放得更低成为一个更低仆人的这个身份。
But for us, what about us? Maybe we are more like last minute go and hold Jesus. Maybe we are like last minute go and hold the Lord's leg one.
可能我们就是，假如是我们的话，我们是这个那个最后一个会去踢足脚的人哈。
我们常常都会讲这一句叫临时抱，我们是基督徒，应该是临时抱
足脚
啊，对对，的确的确有一个讲员就是这样跟我讲的。我们就换，我们已经，我们是基督徒，就要改换一点 ，OK。But you know the meaning, OK? You know the meaning. Yet in the scripture, come back to the scripture, baptizing you with water means that the John the Baptist buried the repentant person in water to end his old life.
所以当用水给你们施洗，就是施洗约翰这样悔改的人埋葬在水里，结束他救人的那一种的生活。
Baptizing you with the Holy Spirit is regarded to those who truly repent and believe in the Lord.
所以用圣灵给你们施洗的，就是使你们可以真实悔罪好，然后悔改相信主的人。
Jesus will immerse believers in the Holy Spirit so that they can receive the eternal life, which is also called the perfect life.
所以当主耶稣把他们浸在圣灵里的时候，就是好比他们已经得到一个完全的生命。
The original text of the Holy Spirit is also known as comforter or helper.
所以圣灵的原文，在这个原文被解释出来，就是这一个的安慰者或者是保惠师。
The Holy Spirit transforms us into more and more like the Lord Jesus Christ in character.
圣灵呢，就是使我们在品格上都能够越来越肖像主耶稣基督。
Now remember, this process of transformation is also called sanctification.
所以这样的转变过程呢，也被称为这成圣的过程。
The Holy Spirit produces the fruit of the Spirit in the heart of believers.
圣灵在信徒的内心结出圣灵的果子。
Believers are being filled with the Holy Spirit.Which is controlled and empowered by the Holy Spirit, are an ongoing pursuit of being filled with the Holy Spirit. It's not just one-time experience.
所以，当信徒被圣灵充满的时候，被圣灵掌管、给力量的时候，这是不断的追求和被圣灵充满，而不仅仅是一次性的那种的经历。
唔系一次，但系是每一次被圣灵充满。
就是不是？
福州话。
你说被哈信信。
Okay, let me repeat again. It's not just one-time experience. It's ongoing all the time. Okay, be filled with the Holy Spirit is an ongoing experience.
就是不仅仅是被圣灵充满一次，而是就是在生命里面继续不断的经历啊神自己圣灵啊这个圣灵的这个带他生长的作为带领。
可以啦，圣灵我们都懂了。Okay.Okay. When the Holy Spirit, when the Sinkling take control of a believer's life, he will gradually transform our old self into the image of Christ.
当我们有圣灵在我们身上的时候呢，我们就会被他自己的这一个被转化成为旧我已经不见了，就转换成为基督的形象。
Dear brothers and sisters, are we willing to abandon the temptation and wicked thoughts through the guidance of the Holy Spirit?
亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，我们是否愿意接纳就是圣灵自己的带领，让我们弃绝那些致死的引诱、邪恶的试探呢？
Indeed, we emphasize that after you believe in Christ, you must be baptized.
我们都知道我们在相信主之后，我们都要被接受洗礼。
However, baptism itself cannot cleanse people from sin.
但是呢，洗礼本身呢，不能洗净人的罪。
But the addition of the Holy Spirit keeps people away from sin.
但是在洗礼的时候，圣灵的加入使人能够离开罪。
Everyone understand? Can follow?
大家可以明白哈。
Well, some already go washroom already tired. Anyway, right now I would like to invite another person come to the stage to share his testimony.
我们现在邀请一位
我们这位弟兄呢，就是叫 Roshan. I would like to invite one of our youth leader to come and share about his assignment. About it's a testimony about his assignment. Okay.
我们来邀请一位弟兄上来分享他的这个见证。
Okay, let me introduce first. We will do in a way of interview way, Q&A testimony way. So I will ask him a question and he will answer me. Okay? And then I will interpret the English later. Okay? 我们会以全程都会以中文来讲，待会我再以英文的来解释。 大概会有五题, okay? We have Q&A section, interview, and share about his testimony. Okay, so, okay, 那中文先啦, okay. 那Rashawn, 我想问一下,这个功课你可以告诉我,还是老师给了怎么样的功课吗? 而且是几时发生的?
这个事情是发生在今年上半年的，不久吧。老师给的功课是，我觉得是有点过分，也有点不过分的感觉啦。就是叫我们自行去构思那个剧情，然后每个学生自己画一个大概至少5秒钟的动画片出来。所以面对这样子的功课，我通常就是躺在床上，然后 想一整个晚上过后，才大概构思出一个简单的一个剧情出来吧。哦，OK，just
what you're trying to say. The assignment was animation have to do in within 5 seconds one, but he try to think a simple way to do it. So 你讲这个是简单的剧情，你能不能详细的给我讲解里面的内容呢？简单就是简单啊，它就是可以。 很轻易就可以满足到老师的要求了，但是我觉得说它的内容就是一种充满黑暗跟暴力的内容了，甚至是有血腥在里面的。那然后它是可以很容易就可以完成，很容易就可以画完了。不过最后我还是打消了这个念头。OK，about
the animation, he was trying to do some kind of like full of darkness or kind of like full of blood or full of negative things in the animation one. Okay, it's kind of like horror thing, which is quite easy to do one. But in the end, he canceled this thought. 诶，中文你会取消这个念头呢？
因为我想这样子一个东西出来，然后我就想，就一直拿不定主意啊，说到底要不要去用这样子的东西。 所以我就决定向上帝祷告，然后我向神祷告过后，上帝也回应了我的祷告。So
he thought of cancel this thought and come and came to the Lord to ask His guidance, to ask His wisdom, to ask what he should be drawing. So 从你在这个祷告当中，你得到什么亮光？神怎么回应你呢？上帝让我回忆起了。 陈华斌牧师的一个信息是关于到撒种的比喻的经文的，牧师不用太感动啊，所以我就翻出了那段经文出来，然后我就看了那个经文，然后我想了一下，想象一下那个画面出来，我就说，蛮不错的。 所以我就开始对他进行了一些专业方面的一些分析啊，开始要讲话。过后最后我最后得到的结果是，他是从5秒钟变到15秒钟去了。Now
just now what he said after he prayed and he thought about Pastor Benjamin's message, which is about the parable of the seed, okay? Parable sowing the seed, and then he thought about using the way to analyze it, and he in the conclusion, if he do the animation from 5 seconds to 15 seconds, okay, it's a big difference, okay, 很大的差别来的, okay,
15秒钟的剧情啊，这样你的老师跟同学他们的回应，他们反应又如何呢？我老师是那种见多不怪啊那种啊，所以他们有什么反应就去做啊，你有本事可以啊。然后我身边的同学呢，他的反应就是这样啊。 你笑啊，lecturer 讲5秒钟，你就做5秒钟啊，爱搞啊，时间多是吗？啊，还有很多不该听的字不要听啊。
哦，OK，哦，OK，so teachers comment，teachers
teacher's comment, which is no comment. But for students' comment of his classmate, it says that he's crazy. Already, just do 5 seconds will do. Who tell you to do so long seconds one? Okay. 面对他们这样讲你过后的，你最后还是决定做什么呢？
面对他们这样讲，我最后我是坚持做那个关于撒种的比喻的那个剧情啊，因为那个是上帝给我指出的一条路，我一定要走到底。然后最后的时候，我是花了5个星期的时间把那个功课做完了，它是一个15秒钟变成21秒钟的最终成果。 然后我交上的功课，成绩是没有那么的理想啊，就是 B 加吧，已经算理想了。感谢主啊，感谢主是
B 加，不是 fail 啊，因为从5秒变21秒，哎，OK。So what he just now say is, after facing all those comments from his classmates, he still persists to follow God's guidance, God's guidance of drawing this parable of the seeds. So in the end, he draw the animation, which is within 21 seconds, and have a good grades on it. 那你在从这个做功课这个经历这过程当中，你学习到什么功课呢？你是要我讲关于完成功课的技巧啊，camera
angle 啊 ，swing emotion 还有什么？没有，不是，属灵上的方面啊，那些我之后再问你啊，不用紧。我觉得，我所学到的东西重点不在于成绩是怎样啊，而是上帝他给我的带领，他把我从一个原本是很简单就可以完成的东西，但是充满了 黑暗的一个剧情，带到一个从来是没有人会想过要去碰的东西，但是却充满了上帝的荣耀了。Amen.
Just now what he said is about, what he learned about. It's not about how good the grade he gets, but it's about learning the experience, learning from drawing, from deciding drawing this dark, full of darkness animation, draw into something people never imagine he will draw the parable of the seeds to glorify the Lord's name. Okay, 我们感谢 Roshan 的这个见证. Thank you, Roshan's testimony. Okay, throughout this testimony, we heard what Roshan mentioned is about God's guidance. Is it?
所以通过这个 Roshan 刚才弟兄这个见证，我们都知道是神自己的带领他。
But we, as a believer, we believe in triune God, isn't it?
我们相信的是那个得胜的君王。我们相信的是三位一体的神，是不是？So
which means we believe that the Father, the Son, and even also including the Holy Spirit is with him when he make this decision to glorify the Lord's name.
所以我们可以看到，就是三位一体的这个。 就是圣父、圣子、圣灵在亲自的引领他做这样的一个决定。Since
we already do this testimony, would you like to see his animation, his result, his production?
所以，既然他刚才已经讲了，他是个21秒的作作，我们要不要看他的这个成果呢
？Shall we look at on the slides? There's no audio one, it's just video. Okay.
哦，没有声音哦，只是有这个影像。So
the seed fall down, the bird take bites away. And then when it grows, suddenly under the sun, it rotted. And then there's the thorns around it. Yeah, by the blood of Jesus Christ, who washed away our sins, we were able to receive this eternal life. Okay? Praise the Lord. Amen. Okay, let's come into this closing, which...
我们来到这个结尾的部分。Advent
is to prepare us for the Lord's coming.
我们知道降临节呢，是让我们预备主自己再来，好，做好准备好。The
first coming of which we look back when we think of His incarnation.
当我们想到他自己道成肉身的时候，主的降世。And
the second coming to which we look forward when we think of His return in glory.
所以第二次他再来的时候，我们是希望可以见到主自己荣耀的这个降临。
Once John the Baptist prepared the people to repent, for the Lord had come.
从前的这个施洗约翰呢，只是预备人悔改，因为主啊已经来了。
Now is the Holy Spirit sanctifying believers to prepare for the Lord's coming again.
所以现在呢，圣灵还要在我们的生命里面圣化信徒的生命，哈，为主的再来做好准备。
The work begun by John was completed by Jesus.
所以约翰开展的工作呢，由主耶稣来完成了。
Next slide. John opened the way for the prophecy of salvation. Jesus came to fulfill the condition of salvation.
所以当在这里呢，约翰为救赎预言开路，耶稣来成就救赎的条件。
John's baptism with water represents repentance, humility, willingness to turn away from sin, and preparation for the coming of the Messiah.
施洗约翰用水施洗是代表着悔改、谦卑、愿意离开罪、预备基督降临的心态。
When Jesus baptized with the Holy Spirit, he completely transformed people into the likeness of Christ.
当耶稣来用圣灵给我们施洗的时候，就是把人完全改变成为拥有基督的样式。
Only Jesus can forgive our sins and give us the strength to live for him.
唯有基督能够赦免我们的罪，并赐予我们力量，能够为基督而活。
The baptism of repentance is the end of the old life, and the baptism of the Holy Spirit is the beginning of a new life.
悔改的洗礼是旧生命的结束，圣灵的洗礼是新生命的开始。
The former part requires confession and repentance, but the latter part also requires the gospel.
前者呢需要认罪悔改，但是后者呢，我们却需要有这个福音。
Therefore, the gospel plus baptism is the way to eternal life.
也因此呢，福音加上洗礼就是永生之路。
Dear friends, if you accept Jesus Christ as your Savior and Lord of your life,
所以亲爱的救主家啊，亲爱的这一些的啊朋友们哈，就是假如我们愿意接受主耶稣基督成为我们的救主以及生命之主的话
，following Him after repenting of your sins.
我们就是认罪悔改，然后跟随他
，and imitate him to live a new life，
然后效法他，我们活出一个新生命来。
If you haven't been baptized, I encourage you quickly to find Pastor Benjamin to start the class and to be baptized.
所以那些啊、你们还没有啊、洗礼的话，弟兄姐妹们哈，我希望你们就是可以尽快的找啊、牧师来接受上这个洗礼班，来接受洗礼。
How many of us have already been baptized? Could we see some hands?
这里多少人是已经接受洗礼过的？好，请举手。
Have to be proud that 你已经是洗礼了，所以举高一点，我们才能看嘛。感谢赞美主嘛，这么我们许多人已经洗礼了，还有少数人，我们更盼望你们一起加入，一起洗礼。Okay. So one last thing. After those who have been baptized.Try to think about how does the Holy Spirit work in your life.
所以那些啊，接受洗礼，我们想想看，就是圣灵怎么样在我们生命里面来做动工了。
Let's pray with one heart.
我们一起来同心祷告。
I ask Brother Tommy to do the closing prayer.
亲爱的阿爸父，孩子们，感谢你今天都能够借着这个牧师啊，这个 Pastor Michael 的这个口来跟我们来传讲，就是这个。福音加上洗礼，我们就是永生的这个路的这个真理的信息。我们感谢主你，因为我们有你成为我们生命之中个人的救赎主以及生命之主，让我们都能够把自己的生命一生都仰望交托在主你自己的圣手当中。不论我们是经过死荫幽谷，或者是生命里面起起伏伏，任何艰难的一切的考验临到我们都单一的来仰望信靠主你，就是我们力量的根源。我们向你来支取，我们仰望主你自己，从此到终我们都认定主你自己就是我们生命的主宰。我们感谢主你，我们有这样的确据仰望交托，祈求感谢祷告奉靠我主耶稣基督圣名的求，阿门。